Hi guys, my name is Kenya and welcome to the YCP. I have with me
Ari.
Well, that's what we do here, so. But yeah, so we were just talking about before we actually started filming while recording is first dates. What do you guys feel about first dates? Are they intimidating? Do you like going on first dates? How is that? Have you ever been on a first date?
Yes, I have been on a date.
And how was that experience? Please
I feel
tell
like
us.
Malik's typical first date is to like the candy store.
Economy candy.
Yeah.
No, that's before the date. So you impress them with the candy.
Impress
afterwards.
Them. All right.
I do like casual first dates though.
Like how? What's casual? Define it.
Like not a fancy restaurant, maybe just like a nice walk, cause you know Roosevelt Island, nice place to go for walks, cause it's like right by the water, or like maybe just some pizza, cheap burgers, things like that.
So what kind of burgers? He said cheap burgers.
I mean cheapish.
Yeah, Malik is basically telling us that he's a broke man.
Yeah,
exactly.
When you're in college and you don't have that many options for food besides like meal plans and stuff, you get cheap burgers or cheap pizza or Chinese or something like that.
Mm. That's true. Chinese
Everyone's in the same situation, so it works out.
That's true. How about you?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know. I typically like to do something where it's like, go to like a restaurant where it's a low-key kind of spot.
Right.
Where you kind of get the chance to get to know the person and talk more. And there's less distractions. Like, I think the dumbest place to take someone is like to something that is very popular and there's going to be a lot of people there and too many moving pieces.
Right.
Like an Irish pub.
I'm
my friend has done that before. I don't understand why.
But you know what? So for some people, that might work.
I mean, for some people. I don't get it myself.
Very exuberant
but.
And, like, you know, just very outspoken. Mm-hmm. Me, I'd probably get intimidated and be like, okay, I'm just going to sit here in the corner, like, yeah.
Yeah.
When I was younger, that would definitely be me.
I feel like also the worst first date can be taking someone to the movies.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, I find that's, but a lot of people do that, and it's just like, no, because how, you're supposed to get to know them, and it's like in a movie, what are you going to do? Just, like, sit there and just watch it, and then after that, go home? Like, that's pretty annoying.
Unless you both are, like, film buffs, whereas, like, you're like, man, forget the audience, like, forget everybody else that's here. We're going to talk about this movie while we watch the movie. And you're, like, talking about, like, different angles in the film. And
everyone's going to hate you in the theater.
Exactly. They're going to throw popcorn at you.
That's why watching a movie isn't necessarily a bad idea. Watching a movie in a theater isn't the best idea.
Oh, you're just trying to find the cheapest route, aren't you?
Netflix and chill.
It factors in. It factors in, yes.
Do you believe in being romantic? Like, I feel like nothing.
I don't believe I am romantic.
Okay.
People can be romantic, just not me.
I agree with you.
Yeah. I feel like my worst first date was like, okay, like this is really serious. I think I told like some of the workers here, but so this guy, he was like a middle school friend and I knew he always had a crush on me. So right after we graduated.
It was a sympathy date.
Yeah. So, you know, I haven't really seen him since middle school. So I was in college at the time. I was like 18, 19. And he's like, oh, let's hang out. And I'm like, sure. So there's this popular restaurant around where we live. And we went and we order. He orders lobster, you know. And I order, and, you know, I'm really simple. So I just order, you know, chicken and rice. You know, it's my thing. So the bill comes. And I don't expect guys, like, to pay for me. But, you know, if they keep on insisting, I'm like, all right, like, whatever. So once the bill came, I grabbed my purse. He's like, no, I got it. I was like, no, it's fine. He's like, no, I got it. And I was like, oh, okay. So then he goes and checks for his wallet, you know, and he's like patting himself like where, like, and I'm like, and I'm in my head, I'm like, do not tell me this. He was like, oh my God, I am so sorry, Kenya. And I'm like, what? I forgot my wallet at home. I was like, oh, I was like, no worries. So I just grabbed the menu. I was just looking at it and I was just like, what was it? I'm trying to, it was more than $40 because he ordered the lobster. Thank God I ordered chicken and like rice. So I'm like, okay, yeah, no problem. Literally, I never saw him.
He had to have set that up.
Yeah.
You don't order lobster.
You think so? I know he felt so bad, but then
he didn't even attempt to reach out to you after that?
No.
Yeah, you got.
But according, because we have a mutual friend, which is his cousin, and her cousin kind of came. Well, his cousin came up to me, and she was just basically saying that he feels really bad and embarrassed. So that's why I kind of believe that. Why
did he felt so bad and embarrassed that he never even thought to reach out to you again?
No.
And why did he order lobster?
And it sucks that Quick Pay wasn't invented back then, because I would have been like, no excuse, Quick Pay me. But yeah, he ordered a lobster.
He said that. Oh, okay. You don't order a lobster and then like say you forget your wallet.
Yeah. And then the other thing being, you said the restaurant was in y'all neighborhood. Like,
It was.
He couldn't have phone home.
I was thinking that too. I was like, you can go home. Like, you don't live far from here.
Call somebody back in the crib. Like, yo, but I left my wallet. Can you run that?
Hopefully he doesn't see this. I'm sorry. I don't want to embarrass him.
I actually hope he's. What is his name?
That's true.
What is his name?
He has a weird name. What's his ethnicity? He has a weird name. They call him Jay. I can say that.
Oh, it's probably like.
It's a weird Dominican name. No, it's a weird Dominican name.
Rafael Maduro's.
No, that's with a J.
She just said he was Dominican.
He was Dominican, yeah. So
see?
He's not trying to be racist.
Don't come for me. Don't come for me. I didn't sing for you. Don't come for me, Ari.
But I think that was probably the worst date I can possibly think of, because I ended up paying $50 for a damn lobster.
Was it the most expensive?
I don't even like seafood.
Did you get a piece of the lobster?
I don't like seafood. That's what pissed me off too. I think he even left some food too.
You know what?
The least he can do is take it home.
Hey, Kenya, I'm hungry and I forgot my wallet.
Oh, negative. Sorry. Nope. Nope, not falling for that again.
You have to order the lobster first and then
the fact that you fell for it the first time is enough.
Cause I like to see the good in people.
Yeah.
So that's naive.
Yeah, he knew too.
So, yeah, I guess it's being naive, but never again. I never heard from him. So now I know next time. Oh, you forgot your wallet.
You know what's the crazy thing? Even if he sees this and he hears this, he's sitting back and he's gonna feel bad. But then the light is gonna turn on and he's gonna go, oh snap! I got a free meal.
Yeah.
Great. That makes me feel. Okay, you guys are making me feel around. So stupid right now.
He's gonna turn around and share this podcast and go, yo, this is the girl I got the free meal from. Remember I told you about that?
Like, this girl is on camera. Like,
yeah.
She's about to be eating. So
yeah. Yeah. Oh man.
Free meal this one time because you're not never seeing his face again.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I see the memes. I see the memes.
Okay, guys, this is not fun. Why you guys are kicking up on me right now?
As far as first dates go, I've only had one first date, and this is when I had snuck off to Georgia to see my friend on her campus, and I had met this dude, really cool dude, and he had this black and yellow Mustang, like a bumblebee type car. So our first date was actually pretty funny. Like, so I met him that day, and he let me ride his longboard. And then I was like, oh my God, like this is when I used to smoke cigarettes. So he drove me to the nearest like gas station. And like in Georgia, it's all highways and big roads. There's like no public transportation, nothing like that. So we had to drive. And he bought me a pack of cigarettes. And then he let me drive his Mustang. Mind you, I don't know how to drive.
How old were you, if you don't mind me asking?
18.
Oh, okay.
So it wasn't like I was like 14. And
so wait.
That's why I was like, wait, how old are you?
He let you, you don't know how to drive, he lets you drive, and then he supported the fact that you wanted cancer.
And this was on the first date.
This alone is a red flag.
Like, so I'm driving the Mustang, and he's just like, and you know how, like you see on TV, like when people are first learning how to drive, they hit the brakes mad hard, like multiple times. That was basically me. I mean, I didn't crash the car, so I was proud of myself. Nobody died, but yeah, I'm a bad driver.
I feel like after that whole process, he looked at you and he's like, oh my God, I love you so much. Let's go out on a date. In the back of his mind, he was like, she is never driving my car again.
No, he lets everybody drive his car, because like he's really like weird like that. I'm just like, you have this badass whip. Mm-hmm. And you just let anybody you meet.
I have a question. Is he like, does he come from money?
No.
Oh, because I was going to say, like, if someone crashes his car, he's going to be like, who cares? I can get another one.
Yeah.
Nah, he doesn't come
so
from
So he's
money.
Broke. Not broke.
No,
but
he's not broke.
I mean, but he can't afford to buy a new broke. Car. Is that,
that doesn't mean he's broke.
I mean, honestly, I didn't ask all those questions. I'm just like, I'm driving a Mustang. Psh, okay. So after I drove That's the Mustang, insane. We, because it was, like, the campus was really, really nice. And there's, like, this part, this, like, little parkish area where there's, like, a pond, like, behind the commons. the apartment sort of area. So we go to the little park and we're just like sitting on his longboard, smoking cigarettes, watching the stars. Like, it was a pretty dope first day.
That's so cute.
Check them out. Watching
we
stars.
We don't have stars here in New York.
Right after.
We don't. We have no
Wait,
stars.
What?
We have stars.
We don't have stars.
But we don't see them.
We don't see them. With all the light pollution, you don't see so many
That depends
stars.
On where you live.
Okay,
like, all
right.
That depends on where
right,
you live.
I get what you're saying. With the street lights. But you just said we don't have any stars in New York. Like the galaxy says, all right, we're going to put stars here, but this is New York. They don't need
them. They don't get no stars.
We can't see the stars here in New York.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that better?
Okay. It was lit.
That was nice. Aw. Did you guys go on a second date?
We had a few more days after that, and then I kind of broke up with him.
Did he let you drive the car again?
I didn't want to drive the car again. I was not trying to kill nobody. I got lucky the first time.
With your entire story, the part that intrigues me the most is that you said you ran away to Georgia. Nobody wants to ask, like, who just says, yo, man, I'm just going to up and leave. You were in Staten Island at this point, right?
No, I was in Brooklyn. I was living on my college campus. So the thing was, I'm not, like, with my circumstances, I'm not supposed to leave the state. And so school had already ended for me, but I'm still living on campus before I had to, like, go home. So I was like, all right, I got some money left over. I'm trying to see my friend. She still got school. I'm about to run away to Georgia. Like, we about to sneak out. And, you know, that 15-hour bus ride was no joke.
Mm-hmm. Wow, you took the bus over there?
Yeah.
You're brave.
I met a lot of creeps on that bus ride. Mm.
Bus rides
I would never
fun.
Do that. That's crazy.
I mean, like, you know, I know how to, like, defend myself and came down, do it, kick you in the throat type stuff. But yeah, I mean, the bus ride wasn't cool, but actually getting there and just, like the whole time I'm on that bus, just adrenaline pumping. Like, I really couldn't sleep. I'm just like, oh, my God, I'm really sneaking to Georgia. Oh, my God.
You're super excited. Was that your first time, like, taking such a long trip?
My first time sneaking off and taking such a long trip.
Okay.
Like, I went to summer camp in first grade. While I was in first grade, and we would like go everywhere, like literally, like we went to Pennsylvania, Philadelphia, to like all these different amusement parks on the East Coast. It was pretty cool.
Okay. That's cool. What's like your guys' favorite places like to go?
The candy store. Charlie's Chocolate Factory.
Yeah, like on vacation.
And I'm not a big chocolate
what?
Fan.
What? Wait, what?
Wait, what did you say?
He's a child murderer. Like, if any of those events, like, see. Yeah, I keep thinking of like, what was her name? Violet.
The one that like got blown up.
Yeah,
that turned
and
into
they're
a
like,
blueberry.
Oh, we're just gonna pop her. We're gonna squeeze the juice out of her. I'm just like, I don't.
But didn't she come back at like the end and she was normal?
That's only because it was technically a cartoon-ish sort of movie. Like, okay. You can't just have children die in a kid's movie and expect everything to be okay.
I think they made a musical of that thing too.
Really?
Yeah, like a Charlie and the Chocolate Factory musical.
Why?
Why not?
Two or three musicals weren't enough.
I mean, like the Oompa Loompas are singing already. Might as well.
Yeah, that's true.
I always found that movie so creepy growing up, honestly.
Well, yeah, it's black comedy.
But, okay.
Everyone getting killed like that in these hilarious ways.
It has black
it's like
comedy.
A sick, twisted humor.
You mean dark comedy?
Oh, that's what you're...
Yeah.
Okay.
Same thing. Black comedy.
Black comedy, dark comedy.
Black humor, dark comedy.
I'm not sure if I like the whole term black comedy.
Yeah, because when I think of black comedy, I think of like Kevin
black
Hart.
Yeah.
So plain.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I like that whole term.
That's what I think of.
I get what you mean, but it's kind of like...
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Yeah. Like...
I always thought of black
comedy. Oh, Kelly's off camera. That's like if they had something like oriental comedy. Right? Exactly. Exactly. It's not okay. It's like, what?
It's very specific.
What?
But, I mean, yeah.
I mean, the term black, it represents an entire, like, culture, like, entire community.
Yeah.
So, I would be very careful saying.
Dark humor, then.
Darker.
Speaking about that, what did you guys think of the Pepsi commercial that just aired this week? Ooh, that had a lot of backlash.
It was lit. Revolution is saved by Pepsi.
Yeah.
But do you guys agree
see why
with
it's
that?
I haven't watched the commercial.
You haven't watched it?
I can
it?
See why they did it from a marketing
I haven't had time to watch anything.
So basically, it's featured with Kendall Jenner.
Uh-huh.
And she's kind of doing
Sunflower.
Like... she's doing like her modeling shoot in the beginning. And she has like a blonde wig. And then she's seeing like looking from like throughout the window. And then she sees like a protest going on. And then she just takes off her blonde wig and just walks and joins the protest. And then you see different, like, minorities and, like, with, like, posters and signs. And then she grabs a Pepsi Cola. Mm-hmm. And then you see like a line of like police officers like lined up, and she just hands over the Pepsi can to the police.
So
and
they just like a bucket and then of Pepsi everything. Just in the middle of the protest? Like,
yeah. So they're trying to say they made first of all they made the protest seem like it's all, you know, like a party, like a block party, and it's just like that's not really what.
Well, it's a commercial, so.
But I'm just like, my thing is, why would you capitalize on social injustice? Like,
Because they're brands and corporations. They capitalize on everything.
I mean, I understand that, but it's just like, do you not understand the severity of this situation? Like, people are dying. People are protesting because people are dying and missing. Mm-hmm. So it's like the fact that you feel the need to throw your brand in the midst of this, like.
And the crazy thing is, it's not just, like, protests. Don't just protest in general, right? So we're not just talking about like a Black Lives Matter protest or a gender identity protest or a feminist protest. We're talking about protest in general. Mm-hmm. So when you like make it almost seem like Pepsi soothes the revolution or Pepsi soothes the moment, it's pretty disrespectful. A lot of my friends were like on Facebook ranting about it, and they started talking about this Kendrick Lamar commercial with it was a Reebok commercial that they pretty much was like Reebok was like the cure for the revolution, and it was like this kid like traveling all throughout like the city, I think it was like Compton, and then he comes to Kendrick and like this loft and drops like this box on the table. Mm. And then they was like, yeah, this is it. Like, no, what?
It's not it, yeah.
I mean, it causes controversy. It causes people to talk about it. I don't agree with it, but I mean, see why they do it.
Pepsi kind of, that's it. They're not showing the commercial anymore. So it's like, I don't think they, like a waste of money.
I think they were like, yo, this is a great idea, right? They was like, yo, this is a great idea. People are going to get behind this. And then they put it out and they was like, this is a dumb idea.
No,
they had to have known there would have been some controversy.
They did that because of the controversy. Like, people are still talking about it even that commercial's not airing anymore.
Yeah.
Like, they knew exactly what they were doing. Like, whether people stop buying it or start buying it, people have Pepsi in their mouths. Like, they're continuing to talk about Pepsi. Like,
I feel like Coca-Cola did something like this too.
I feel like they did.
Maybe not to that extent, but probably. It wouldn't surprise me if they did.
Yeah. And a lot of people were blaming Kendall, too. Like,
man, she just got a chest,
man.
Like,
she's just the face, honestly.
Yeah, man. Like, yeah. I'm not, I can't place her at fault. One, that's her job, right?
Yeah.
She showed up. She did what she had to do. It's not like she's in the front line of any protest at all. Like, I think the only thing she would ever protest is if they cut her show off.
The only thing that they were saying...
She's a part of that Kardashian show,
she's a part
show,
of the Kardashians, right? Keeping up the Kardashians.
Gotta keep up with them.
Like, that's the only thing I would... let's be real. As far as her, like... What is there to say?
And what they're saying is that, like, she's smart enough to know, like, while she was filming, saying, well, like, this is not right. So they were saying that once, you know, she was in the process of it, and once they were telling her, like, kind of, like, what to do...
Mm-hmm.
Kind of to speak up and say, I don't want to be part of this anymore.
I feel like if you look at the Kardashians as a whole,
mm-hmm.
they promote brands that they don't even use. So all this was promotion to her.
That's awesome.
It's not like, oh, okay, well, this is wrong. Let me not do this. It's just like, this is a brand. I can make money off of this brand. I don't really care what they're doing. This is my job. I'm just going to do my job and make this money. That's it.
Yep.
You know what's crazy? Maybe she thought about, maybe going into it, she probably said to herself, what would Beyonce do? like, I don't know, like, she went into it and was just like, man, yo, Beyonce came out in the Super Bowl. She was wearing the froze with the black on and was really militant. I'm gonna be just like Beyonce and go out here and do this damn Pepsi commercial, and I'm gonna get this cup of Pepsi, because
I mean,
what
would
Beyonce
do? Doesn't Beyonce
has a Pepsi commercial? You know what?
Yeah, she's like, and even
a lot of celebrities just have a history of doing really weird commercials, right?
No,
just celebrities in general, not Beyonce. And I'm like, Mary J. Blige did a Burger King commercial about a chicken sandwich.
Did she really?
Yeah.
I haven't seen that one.
Yeah, it was really bad. It was really, really bad. There's just like this long-standing history of celebrities doing like really poor, having really poor judgment with choosing the type of stuff they attach to them.
Or just not caring.
Just chasing the check.
I feel like with something like that, they should at least, I don't know. I feel like it was too much. I thought personally that was over the top. Mm-hmm. But that shouldn't happen. I feel like everything was okay until the whole cop line and how mm-hmm. she gave it to him, and then it's like, oh, everything's good. And like, no, it's not. People are dying every day mm-hmm. because of what's going on. And even Martin Luther King,
his daughter,
posted on Twitter saying that I should have gave my dad a Pepsi, or my dad. Yeah. I mean,
if only dad knew the power of Pepsi.
Yeah. Only dad knew the power of Pepsi. So, yeah, it's a heavy topic, but hopefully Pepsi learned their, you know, lesson and not to do that again.
Unless they try it again in the next 10 years. Who are we to say?
That is so true.
Next time it's Coke's turn.
But, yeah, thank you guys for coming on. This was fun.
Thank you. You are welcome.
Thank really you. Appreciate your presence. So, yeah, like that is it, guys. We'll be back next week, and I hope you guys enjoyed.
Thanks, Jesus.
Bye.